So more and more our customers and our stakeholders, so that's all the businesses that we work with across the campus, are asking about how do they make emissions reductions and how are we working towards our net zero targets. This is coming not only from people who are flying on planes, but also from the businesses that we work with at our airport. So one of the ways that we're looking at doing that is by decarbonising our fleet. We have long set sustainability targets for both Dublin Airport and for DAA. And at Dublin Airport, that includes a 50% reduction in our carbon and energy emissions over the next 7 years up to 2030. So finding an alternative to diesel where we can transition our ground transport over really helps us in reaching our 2030 targets, but also in getting to our net zero ambition for 2050. We have introduced a huge amount of electric light fleet. We'll have 100% electric light fleet on campus by 2025, but the heavy fleet is really the one that was challenging for us. As you can imagine, some of the vehicles that we have, both for pulling planes or for cleaning, are absolutely huge. So although there is a massive transition going on to electric vehicles right now, we're never really going to be able to get our hands on those in an electric version, not as the market looks right now and not as technology exists. So we were looking around to the market to see what other options we had to move away from diesel. That's how HVO came up as an option for us.
We have conducted a HVO trial in April this year, whereby we used 7 different categories of vehicles. We covered 10,000 litres of fuel, and that trial was a successful lead on to a full transition towards HVO. The types of vehicles that we use are everything from ambulances and fire trucks to snow and ice clearing vehicles, agricultural tractors, and then again we have a number of light fleet vehicles, jeeps, passenger cars, that operate on diesel as well on our airside and landside. And our objective is to transition them fully towards HVO before the end of the year. The impressive piece of transitioning towards HVO was the ease of transition. So it is a direct replacement, so we had no additional investment required in infrastructure or modifications required to the vehicles to take the HVO. Not only is it obviously reducing our carbon footprint, but it is also making the engines run cleaner because of less carbon buildup in manifolds, and essentially it means that the cars will perform far better than running on conventional diesel.
So we're hoping to set the stage, I suppose, for other people to feel comfortable to make that transition as well. If we can prove that it's working for us, then we feel that lots of other people on the campus will make that transition, and that will improve the emissions reductions across the whole of the airport.